Hey guys, and welcome to the next episode of Kirby's Return to Dreamland. Today we are going to start White Wafers with Stage 1 and Stage 2. So let's go! Start out with a brewing hat there. Taco Joe. Got fighter with that. Although there's chili in it, we need ice. Next, we need fire for this area. That we get the first energy sphere, which is nice. It's also reinforced with Joe or Finder. I don't think we got fighter in this playthrough yet, I don't know. I don't think so, but I don't know. Yeah, I'm checking the camera angle, that's what I'm saying. Why? Fighter isn't really good for fighting enemies. I mean, they're good for fighting enemies, but I mean, just like on that this part over here, where they were jumping over the pits, and they're not too interested in that. That thing remains. Wow, I never knew that. Never knew it went into loading zones. I think I forgot. I know it's obvious there's an entry sphere up here, don't try to hide it. They're getting beaten up pretty bad. You dodged that. You can't dodge the fight of the 300. I wanna uppercut these guys. Good thing I did. There's Needless. I didn't know you were in this game, but bye bye. Oh. Oh, dang it. There's Walking down there. I wish I could have gotten it. Hey! Dang it, I did notice that Needless. Okay. I'll show off some more of the ice. Ah. Freeze. Stay frozen. Mid boss. Who is it? Gigantic. Ha! Oh god. Ah. Take your get sword. Meta Knight, even though he has the sword ability, he can't do this move. I don't know why. I think he can do all the other sword moves, so why not that one? Stage 2. Oh, 40 energies. Yeah. Okay, stage 2. Here's the next stage. There's some really cool music it has. Meteor ice abilities. Plus, who are those guys? They look kinda like the Snowbirds from Kirby 64, but I wouldn't know. Because they both look different. They're probably not the same. Ninja. Dang it, I should have got that plant. Ah! Dang it. Those enemies with the rhino horns remind me of one of the enemies from New Super Mario Bros. DS. I'm saying DS because they didn't reappear in any other games other than Pokemon. They were like these beetle guys. Looks like I need fire, so I'll go get fire. Jump into this thing. Fire. So I'm guessing what we do is this. I'm guessing. Oh, there we go. Dang, I barely made it. What I meant is dang, I almost didn't make it. Just for a second there, it sounded like I didn't make it. Which would be weird because I did make it, and if I'm saying I didn't make it, then if I did make it, then I wouldn't. Whatever. For some reason, this level seems like it could be in a Mario game. The reason saying is because there's a lot of falling icicles and enemies that look like Mario. Maybe not the bonus ones. Second one, I think. I don't know if this place has an ultra ability in it, but I don't know. Super ability. Just thinking of the ultra sword. Bunch of Rockies. Sorry, I only use stone for fighting purposes. Well, I guess I have to use stone here. Just slide down the slopes. Uh-oh. Okay, now we're fine. I like about stone is that you're invulnerable to anything. It also is useful for my boss attacks videos where I showcase the boss attacks so I don't have to avoid them and don't have to get hurt on them. Super bomb. I think this is the first time we've shown off the super hammer. I don't remember. The grand hammer. In this mode. And what I don't like about the stone ability in this game is that, see, when you're charging this, you can't move it like you can in a later game. I can see why they didn't think of that, but I would have liked if they came up with a feature in this game. There's also the spinning feature that was also introduced to Lux, but that thing's just a spinning thing, all it does is let you see it. So, bye bye, Bob. Grand Hammer Time. Of course, this would be in a new Super Mario Bros. Game, I mean, this section, because new Super Mario Bros. Games don't have superpowers. It'd be nice if they did have, a section in a level where there's no time limit and you could completely crack everything, but it's fine without. In fact, I don't really find the Hypernova sections in Kirby Plus to be too helpful. Not too helpful, they're helpful. Not too enjoyable, that's what I mean. Because Hypernova is a good ability, but the sections are kind of a long time to get through. And of course they removed it in the extra mode because you play as King Dedede there. You can't use copy of it. Show yourself head on stand. No. I don't think you're gonna get away with that. There's the portal. Portal opens. It's time to go in. Well done. Okay, good. I checked the camera angle was in the right place. Looks like this is a key area where we have to use the key. Oh god. Oh, good thing it didn't destroy the key. I thought it would. Ah! Dang it. Well, we're gonna have to go through that again. Put the key in here. Put the key up here. You need to take the key to this. Also, for some reason, the music that plays in this level also plays for Kirby Triple Deluxe, but it plays for the grass and snow level. Well, it is only in Royal Rose Exchange. The one without Hyper. So that's why I'm doing this. Technically, the second last level of the game. Because know that we go to stage 5. The X stages are technically the last level. Dang it, I have to beat this guy without any ability. I forgot to pick up my ability, so... too busy talking. Rah! Dang it. Fight me! At least he doesn't have a lot of HP. Dang it, this is ice. I didn't realize. See, look, it's ice. Oh. I keep thinking he's gonna shoot out those energy balls. It's not. Yeah. Dang, I've never seen this attack before. Combined with the Krako beat. That's what I like to nickname whenever they use like an electric beat like that as their attacks. Because that's like Krako's signature move. He surrounds himself with a beam that goes clockwise. That's like Krako's signature move. So I like to call that move the Krako beam. It's Krako in every single game he appears in. There's guaranteed to use that move. And right here's our gold game. Jump. To one. Yes, got it. Too bad Krako is in this game. He's a fun boss to fight. He became an actual boss in Triple Deluxe, but in Planet Robobot, he was part of the Holo Defense API, which is a boss that sends out 4 mini-bosses. Because the Krako in that game doesn't have any over-the-top special attacks, only his signature ones, and takes 3 hits to defeat with normal Kirby. Anyway, next episode we're doing stage 3 and stage 4. This is the first level to have a stage 5, so we will be doing stage 5, we'll get its own episode. Stage 3 and stage 4 we'll be doing next episode, so see you then.